Hello Techie, welcome back to my YouTube channel Tech Solution. I want to teach you the Python as the faster way as possible and more practical way. Now before we get started, please subscribe to my YouTube channel and turn on the notification by clicking on bell icon. In the last video, basically I try to cover if else condition. Okay. What is if else condition? An else statement can be combined with an if statement. An else statement contains the block of code that executes if the conditional expression in the if statement resolves to zero or a false value. The else statement is an optional statement and there could be at the most only one else statement following if. What does mean? We will go example one by one. Okay, let's start with Python condition and if statement. Python support the usual logical condition from the mathematics. Okay, what does it mean? It will support A equal to B, that is equal conditions. Okay, then it will not equal. Is not equal to B, and then it will less than A less than equal to B, then less than equal to B, A less equal to B, greater than B, A is greater than B, greater equal to B, then or equal to B, A greater equal to B. Okay, this is the condition in the Python. Okay, logical condition. This condition can be used in several ways, most commonly in if statement and loops. Okay, an if statement is written by using the if keywords. Let's start with if condition. A equal to 33 and B equal to 200. Okay. If condition. B is greater than A. Column always remember, enter, print. B is greater than A. Okay. What will print? 200 is greater than 23, that is 2, right? Then it will print B is greater than A. Let's run it from here, right? B is greater than A, that is clear now. In this example, we use two variables, right? A and B, which are used as a part of the if statement to test whether B is greater than A. As A is 33 and B is 200, we know that 200 is greater than 33. So if we print to screen that B is greater than A, right? That is clear. Indentation. Python relies on indentation, white space at the beginning of a line, to define scope in the code. Other programming languages often use curly braces for this purpose. Basically, is when I saw right column here, then we are going to enter C, that automatically it will come. But in other programming language, just like a C, C++, C sharp, then we are using curly braces to know, okay, after the condition it satisfies, it will go inside that. But in the Python, then we are using indentation. Okay, that means space. This space is there, right? To start with next line of code. Okay, if you are not going to use indentation, then what will happen? It will give the error. Let's run it and see. Right? Indentation error here. Okay? Because we are not giving space here. Okay? Now if you are going to run, this is one tab. Then it will give B is greater than A. Okay? Now it's clear now. Now we'll go with another example, else if. The else if condition keyword basically is the Python way of saying If the previous condition were not true, then try this condition. Okay, let's go with the example. A equal to 33 and B also equal to 33. Okay, if B is greater than A, then print B is greater than A. Okay, else if A equal to B, then print A is equal to B. Okay, that is clear. Okay, A is 33 and B is 33, right? B is greater than A, that means 33 is greater than 33, that is false, right? Because B is equal to A, not a greater, not is less, right? Then it will come to this condition, A equal to B, then it will say yes, that 33 equal to 33, then it will say okay, print A is equal to B, right? Let's run it. Okay, A is equal to B, that is clear. In this example, A is equal to B, right? So the if the condition is not true, then what will happen? It will go to else if condition, that is true, right? If this is not true, then it will come else if condition, that will true, right? So we print to screen A is equal to B, right? That is clear now. Now we'll go with another example, else keyword. First, what we'll need first, okay, I'm going to remove this. First, if condition. Second, else if condition. Okay. Now we'll go with else keyword. Else keyword catches anything which is not caused by preceding condition. Okay, what does it mean? Let's go with the example. A equal to 200, B equal to 33. Else condition. And then if B is greater than A, then print. What will print? B is greater than A. Okay. If this if B A equal to B, then print A is equal to B. If both the condition is false, then what will print? Let's go with else condition. Okay, and then print A is greater than B. Okay, now we'll go with example. Is 33 is greater than 200? No, this is false, right? Then it will come to here, else if condition. What will checking here? If 200 equal to 33, that is false also, right? Now if both the condition will false, what will happen? It will go to its condition and print yes, A is greater than B, right? If it's not also, then it will print, because both the if and else if condition is false, then it will comes under else condition. It will print A is greater than B, right? Let's run it. Okay, A is greater than B. Is it clear now? Now we'll go with another example. Let's remove this one. Just like A 200, B equal to 33. If B is greater than A, then print B is greater than A. Else print B is not greater than A. Okay. Let's start with if condition. Okay, 33 is greater than 200. No, right? If it's the first condition is false, then it will fall into else condition. Okay, then it will be B is not greater than A, and it's true also. B is not greater. 33 is not greater than 200, right? Greater than 200. Let's run it. Okay, B is not greater than A, right? This is clear now. Now we'll show you shorthand if. If you have only one statement to execute, you can put it on the same line as the if statement. This is short way of point. Shorthand if condition. If we will go with 200, B is equal to 33. In one line we can write also if A is greater than B, then print A is greater than B. This is shorthand, right? Okay, 200 is greater than 33, that is true, right? Then it will print A is greater than B. Let's run it. Okay, A is greater than B. That is okay. Now I will check with same shorthand if else condition. If you have only one statement to execute, one for if and one for else, then you can put it all on the same line. Fifth one, shorthand if else. Okay, let's remove A equal to 2, B equal to 330. Okay, print A if A is greater than B, else print B. It's little confusion to see first time. I tell you how it will work. See what happened here. If A is greater than B, that means if 2 is greater than 330, okay, then what will do? It will print A. That is true? No. Right? Then what it will print? It will print B. Okay? This is first print A and this is condition. Okay? Let's run it. It will print B. Okay? It will print B, right? Because 2 is not greater than 330, right? That's why it's print B. Okay? This is shorthand if else condition. Okay? Now we'll go with another example, multiple else statement on the same line. Okay, let's remove it. A equal to 330, B equal to 330, print A if A is greater than B, else print equal. Okay, if A double equal to B, else print B. Okay, what happened here? If A is greater than B, then print A, else print equal. If A equal to B, this one, else print B. Okay, it will print equal, right? First it will check this. This is one if condition, this is second, and this is third one. Okay, this A is 330 and B is 330 also, right? Then this will come else condition and it will print equal. Okay, let's run it. Right, this is print equal because if A equal to B, then it will print this else condition, print. Okay, otherwise it will print B. Let's go with this way. If this condition true, then it will go with else condition. Okay, if this condition is false, then it will go with this condition. Okay, now this way. This is clear now. Now we'll go with AND keyword. AND keyword is logical operator and it's used to combine conditional statement. Okay, let's go with the example. Sixth AND operator. a equal to 200, okay, b equal to 33, c equal to 500. If a is greater than b and c is greater than a, then print both conditions are true. Okay, let's see, is it true or false? Okay, 200, right? 200 is a, right? 200 is greater than b, means 33. That is true, right? That is true. Now c means 500. 500 is greater than a, means 200. That is also true, right? Both are true, means true and true means true. That means if both the condition will true, then it will come inside and print both the condition are true. Okay, this will print. Let's run it. Right, both the condition are true. Okay, this is AND condition. If anyone is false, then it will not print anything. Just like if this is true and this is false, right, then result will be false. If true and false, that result will be false and it will not print anything. If you want to print anything, then we have to use this condition and print both conditions are not true. Okay, let's run it. Right, both conditions are not true because one is true and this one is false. Then it will not fall into if had it fall into this condition, and that will print both the conditions are not true. Right, this is clear now. Now we'll go with OR operator. Seventh OR operator. Okay, what the OR keyword we do? OR keyword is logical operator and is used to combine conditional statement. If any of the condition will true, then it will print true. Means if A, okay, let's go with the example, then it will be clear. That means true or false, that will come true only. Okay, but if you're going to use AND here, then it will come false. That I mean. Okay, let's go with example. A equal to 200, B equal to 33, C equal to 500. If a is greater than b or a is less equal to c, right, then print at least one of the condition is true. At least one of the condition is true. Okay, now go with the example. Okay, first is 200. 200 is greater than b, 33. That is true, right? Now if a is 200 less equal to 500, right, that is true also. Both are true. A and b is also true, and a is less than c is also true. That means both are true, then it will be at least one of the condition is true. Let's run it. Okay, at least one of the condition. If a greater than c also, that is false, right? If a is greater than c, right, 200 is greater than c, means 500, that is false, right? Then it will also print at least one of the condition is true, because this is true and this is false. That means true or false means that is true only, right? Then again it will print this one, right? At least one of the condition is true. If a is less than b, that is false. 200 is less than 33, right, that is false. And a is greater than c, means 200 is greater than 500, that also false. Then it will not go inside, right? Then if you want to print this condition, then what you have to do, print both the condition are false. Okay, let's run it. Then it will come else. Right, both the condition are false. Right, that is clear now. Now we'll go with nested if can. Let nested if. Okay, nested if, you can have if statement inside the if statement. This is called nested if statement. Means multiple if condition, one inside one. Just like s equal to 41, if x is greater than 10, then it will print a of 10, right? If x is greater than 20, then it will print, and also a of 20. Right, else it will print but not above 20. Okay, let's go with again. Okay, 41 is greater than 10. 41 is greater than 10, right? That is true. Okay, then it will print a of 10. It will print first what it will print, a of 10. Now it will come inside second one, is x is greater than 20, 41 is greater than 20, right? Then it will print and also a of 20. Okay, if this condition is true, then it will not go this condition, right? Then what will print above 10 and also above 20. Okay, let's run it. Right, above 10 and also have above 20. Okay, this is clear now. If is nested if condition, now go with final one, pass statement. Ninth and final one, pass statement. Okay. If statement cannot be empty, but if you have some reason have an if statement with no content, then put in pass statement, avoid getting an error. Okay, what does mean? If a is equal to 3 and b is equal to 33, right? If b is greater than a, and if you are not going to pass, then what will happen? It will give error, right? Syntax error. Okay, right. But if you avoid this error, then we have to use pass. Okay, that is clear. And if you are going to run, then we will not get any error. Let's run, but it will not print anything because we are not using any print statement here, right? Let's run it. Okay, it's not printing anything, right? And but it will not give any error also, right? Pass statement is clear now. For today, that's it. Thank you so much for watching my video. I am going to post more and more video on daily basis. So if you want to watch my video in future, just subscribe it below bell icon with all. He will notify you when my new video will come. And please don't forget to like and share. We will meet once again in new video with new topic. Thank you.